Previously, we have already tested how much performance we are losing by using an eGPU with a Thunderbolt connection. Now it's time to test OcuLink. Conditions will be the same. Run the benchmarks on a desktop PC, then pull out the RTX 4090 and connect it as an external GPU via OcuLink and do the same benchmarks on the same PC. But first, let me show you which eGPU dock I'll be using. I got it from AliExpress for 69 euros. Package included the eGPU dock itself, 24-pin connector, an OcuLink cable and M.2 adapter for connecting to a laptop, mini PC or in my case a desktop PC. Good thing is that you can use an old Dell power adapter with an 8-pin connector, and the video card can be powered from the 6-pin output from the eGPU dock itself. They're cheap, but be prepared to spend time searching for them. And the power output is limited to 150 watts. Since it's not enough for my GPU, I'm going to use a power supply for this. Plugging in the 24-pin connector, insert your GPU, then power connection for it, and OcuLink cable. At this point, if your device has an OcuLink port, you can directly connect it and only after that you can turn on your device. It's not hot swappable, so whenever you need to connect or disconnect the eGPU, your device should be switched off. Since I'll run benchmarks on a PC, I'll use an M.2 adapter and plug the OcuLink cable into it. And I ended up with this weird setup. The eGPU dock is too small to hold the graphics card in a standing position, and I couldn't find a case or a stand for it. So if you plan to get a dock like this for a big graphics card, think twice or just get another one. The RTX 2060 seems to hold up on it, but it's painful to watch. Anyway, we're all set to launch. Right away we check the bandwidth speed and we see over 62 gigabits per second. For comparison, Thunderbolt has around 23, and when GPU is connected directly to the motherboard, 232 gigabits per second. And now let's see how this difference will be noticeable in games. To make us less CPU dependent, all benchmarks will be performed in 4K resolution, without DLSS, but with ray tracing if supported. I will also show some gameplay so you can compare frame time and 1% low. Just like last time, we can see that the result can vary from game to game, with performance loss ranging from 0 to 20%. On average, we get around 10% performance loss. But will this result match with another graphics card? After all, I also have an RTX 2060. I'll check in a few games at 1440p resolution with mixed settings. This time performance loss averaged 11% in a list of 4 games. If we compare RTX 2060 and 4090 side by side, the only one with a bigger difference is the Callisto protocol. But I'm not sure that the performance is different because of the graphics cards, but rather because of the graphics settings. Obviously, I couldn't use the same settings on the 2060 afterwards, and I wasn't smart enough to run these tests on the same settings right away. And now I'm too... tired. And now I'm too tired to do it again. Anyway, I think you have a point that we can connect any GPU with OcuLink, and losing about 10% of performance isn't that big of a deal. But those who already ran to connect 4090 to their mini PC or handheld, keep in mind that the result may be different. It's worth not forgetting that there is a mobile CPU, which can be a bottleneck in some games. And if you think that my i5-13500 is weak for the RTX 4090, check out my video where I compare it to 14900K. And let me know what do you think about this experiment.